Have you ever wanted to create a scrolling background that moves behind your sprite as it stays in place? Let's explore one method to create a scrolling background, but make one that your user can control and explore by using keyboard keys to make the background move in different directions. Scrolling backgrounds like this could be used in games or animations or informational projects. To start this project, I've selected a sprite that has a few costumes, so it looks like it is walking. I have also created a few background sprites, each with some objects in place so we can see them moving past my walking sprite. I have to create my backgrounds as sprites instead of as backdrops, because if you look at the blocks available for backdrops, you'll notice that motion blocks aren't present. In order to move my backgrounds, they'll need to be set up as sprites. I want to line up all my background sprites end to end, so each comes after the one before. I'll set the Y position of all my backgrounds at 0 to center the costume on the stage vertically. The stage is 480 pixels wide, so I'll set the X position of my first background at 480 times 0. If I click on this expression in the script area, I can see that equals 0. So the first background sprite is positioned at X0, Y0. For the second background sprite, I'll set the X position to 480 times 1, completely to the right of my first background sprite. The third background sprite will be set at 480 times 2, and so on for each background. Now I need to create a variable that will help me change the position of all these background sprites simultaneously. I'm going to call my variable scrollX. On my main walking sprite, I'm going to create a script that first sets the scrollX variable to 0. Then, my script will forever change scrollX by -5 if the right arrow is pressed, and change scrollX by 5 if the left arrow is pressed. If I test this code right now, nothing will happen because I haven't used this variable as an input anywhere. So I need to go back to my background sprites and change my expression. So the X position is set at scrollX plus 480 times 0. Let's see what the effect is. So as the scrollX value goes up, the background moves right. As the scrollX value goes down, the background moves to the left. I've got a scrolling background the user can control. And each time I want to add a new background, I just need to copy this code sequence from another background sprite and simply adjust the number I am multiplying 480 by. Now that this is working, I can tinker with my program to account for any unexpected behavior or to add additional elements. For instance, I can use point and direction blocks to turn my character. Whoops, when the character goes left, they're upside down. I can use a set rotation style block so the character only points left or right. And what about changing the costume to look like the character is walking? I could add it under the point and direction blocks in both places in my script. But if I test this, the walking looks too fast for me. I can try to add a wait block, but when I test this, it's slowing down the animation. Instead, I'm going to set the walking animation as a separate script that happens if the left or right arrow keys are pressed. Now, with the slight wait in place, this animation is looking more natural. What if I want to ensure that the walking sprite can't go off the edge? And what if I want to add another sprite that scrolls along with one of the background sprites and can interact with my main walking sprite? Try different solutions. Try variations. For instance, I could use a scrolling background in a platformer game where the main sprite not only scrolls the background scene left and right, but I can also jump and interact with items in the scene for points. You can see my work in progress here. What obstacles or point scoring opportunities and challenges would you create? Or you could make a top-down animation or game that behaves similarly. Notice that in this version, I have not only set up a scroll X variable, but a scroll Y variable as well. The stage is 360 pixels tall, so notice each of my ground sprites is set at 480 times a number to set the position along the X axis, and 360 times a number to set the position along the Y axis. What kinds of things will you try? How will you use a user-controlled scrolling background to enhance your project?